and Drug Administration is changing the status of many antimicrobials used in feed. As of January 1, 2017, animal producers will no longer be able to buy medicated feed over the counter if it contains antimicrobials that are important for human health. Instead, animal producers will have to work with a veterinarian to use those antimicrobials in feed. Also, on January 1, 2017, animal producers will no longer be able to use those antimicrobials in feed for growth promotion or feed efficiency. Why these changes? To address the issue of antimicrobial resistance. Bacteria become resistant to the antimicrobial drugs used to fight them, which is what the term antimicrobial resistance means. This resistance is not just an issue in human medicine, it's an issue in veterinary medicine too. Antimicrobial resistance poses a threat to both human and animal health. FDA Center for Veterinary Medicine, or CVM, has the responsibility to address the issue of antimicrobial resistance in animals. To do that, CVM has been working with the drug sponsors to voluntarily change the marketing status and remove the production claims of these antimicrobials. The change affects only medically important antimicrobials, the antimicrobials used for human medicine. The changes do not affect antimicrobial drugs approved for use in animals but not deemed important for human medicine. Specifically, what are the changes? First, animal producers will not be able to buy medically important antimicrobials over the counter as of 2017. The use of medically important antimicrobial products will be permitted only when authorized by a veterinarian and used in compliance with the rule known as the Veterinary Feed Directive Rule, or VFD rule. Second, statements that the antimicrobial in feed helps with growth promotion or feed efficiency, these are also known as production claims, will no longer appear on labels for feed containing medically important antimicrobial drugs used in animal feed or drugs used in water. The focus of this video is on feed use. The change to the labels means that animal producers will no longer be permitted to use feed containing medically important antimicrobials for growth promotion or to increase feed efficiency in their animals. What is the VFD rule? It's a rule implemented by the FDA that permits veterinarians to authorize the use of certain drugs. Drugs CVM has approved as VFD drugs in or on animal feed. The rule specifies the roles and responsibilities of the three parties involved in the process of authorizing, distributing, and feeding a VFD feed: the veterinarian, the client, who's typically the animal producer, and the distributor. Why do veterinarians have to be involved? Because veterinarians have the medical training necessary to diagnose the disease and to identify the appropriate antimicrobial for the specific situation. The veterinarian's involvement is expected to help reduce misuse or overuse of antimicrobials, thus helping to ensure judicious use of antimicrobials. What is a VFD drug? A VFD drug is an animal drug that FDA has approved to be used in feed only under the veterinarian's supervision. So, a VFD drug is used to make a medicated feed that can be fed to animals only when authorized by a veterinarian. The veterinarian may make such authorization only under a valid veterinarian-client-patient relationship, or VCPR. This is a set of requirements for the working relationship the veterinarian has with the client, the animal's owner or caretaker, and in some cases, the state in which the veterinarian works will establish criteria for the VCPR. Otherwise, FDA establishes such criteria. What is a VFD feed? Simply, it's a feed containing a VFD drug. It can contain a single drug or a combination of drugs. A type A medicated article is the product with the most concentrated form of a drug. It's used to manufacture type B and type C medicated feeds. When type B and type C medicated feeds contain a VFD drug, they're called VFD feeds. Similar to type A medicated articles, type B medicated feeds contain concentrated levels of drugs and have to be diluted to an approved type C medicated feed drug level before being fed to animals. Only type C medicated feeds can be fed to animals. All VFD drugs and feeds, regardless of whether they are type A, B, or C, must be correctly labeled. Their labeling and advertising must include this statement: Caution. Federal law restricts medicated feed containing this veterinary feed directive drug to use by or on the order of a licensed veterinarian. Here's how the VFD regulation works. To write a lawful VFD order, the veterinarian must have a valid VCPR with the animal producer and the animals that will receive treatment. The VFD order, which authorized the producer to feed a VFD feed to animals, must be written out. It's not lawful if it's simply told to the animal producer or feed manufacturer. The VFD order must contain several pieces of information, including information identifying the veterinarian, the client, and the animals to receive the VFD feed. It must also have a description of the VFD feed and information about the last day the feed can be used. A lawful VFD order must be completed and signed by the veterinarian. The veterinarian gives a copy to the client. The client can take a second copy of the order to the VFD feed distributor, or the veterinarian can send the copy directly to the distributor. A veterinarian can electronically sign an electronic version of the order if the veterinarian can meet the requirements for an electronic signature. A copy of the VFD can be hand-delivered, mailed, faxed, or sent electronically to the distributor. The distributor must have a copy of the VFD order before giving the VFD feed to the animal producer, and the animal producer can give the VFD feed to only those animals authorized by the VFD order. The veterinarian, the feed distributor, and the livestock producer all must keep a copy of the VFD order for at least 2 years from when it was issued. For additional information about the VFD rule, including a complete description of the information required for a lawful VFD order, please go to www.fda.gov/safefeed. We also have videos posted there with specific VFD requirements for veterinarians, distributors, and clients. Thank you. Veterinary